Read the question. The given flowchart models the generation of some numbers in a certain range. Write the first three and the last three numbers that it generates. So you have a flowchart. First of all, we'll get the flowchart done. So here we go. This is the flowchart we have, right? So in the question, they are saying find out the first three outputs and the last three outputs. That's my question. So in my answer script, I need to say first three. This is the answer for the first one, and I need to say the last three. Now instead, when you are writing the answer, if you give a series, if you are like, okay, you are saying some numbers and you are kind of putting commas, if you say something like this, the marking scheme strictly says no series is allowed. Understood? The marking scheme strictly says no series will be allowed and don't give any marks. Okay, so be careful. They are saying the first three and last three. So you need to separately show that these are the first three ones and these are the last three numbers. Okay, so let's find out what are the first three. So understanding this thing, first thing happening is what are the variables I have? I have two types of variables, that is x and t. This is how you understand the flowchart. So at the beginning, x is 1, t is also 1. Okay, so first thing happening is displaying t. So t will be displayed as 1. I got the first value. I got the first value. What is funny there? Someone looking here? Yeah? No? Then? Okay, then anyway, right? So is it the way I'm kind of, you know, working right here? It's totally broken. I'm really, really afraid of working on this thing, right? Definitely it will break my knee, okay, if I kind of fall down, that's definite. So anyway, because I am a pretty old man, right? So next thing, I got the first value, that's 1 from here. So during the second cycle, what is happening? Before the second cycle, right, x is becoming x plus 1, which means 1 plus 1, x becomes 2. And next thing is, t is assigned with t plus x. So t is 1, 1 plus 2, t becomes 3. And it is checking, is t greater than 50? Not yet. So it is going again. So in the going, it is displaying t. So the second value there I get as 3. And I need 3 values. Okay, so I need to update this. So updating means you need to kind of say x equals x plus 1, which means, right? 2 plus 1, x becomes 3. And next thing is t equals t plus x. So 3 plus 3, it becomes 6. So I got the third value, that is 6. So can you have some sort of a sequence right there? What is that? 1, 3, 6. What type of an order is that? What type of an order is that? That's triangular numbers. Am I correct? Those are triangular numbers. See? 1, then you have 3, then you have 6, then you may have 10. This will go like that. And tell me, what is the closest triangular number for 50? If you go by that, what is the closest value for 50? Hello? 50. Now you guys have done progression and all, right? So tell me, what would be the closest one to 50? Okay, is it too hard for you? Then you can kind of, you know, fill up the pyramid if you want. That's another method of doing it. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here 1, here 3, here 6, here 10. This is 15. And it will be next 15 plus 6. What is that? 21. then 21 plus 7, that is 28, and 28 plus 8, 36, 36 plus 9, 45 plus 10 is 55, that is more than 50. So there it stops. So what are the last three values? Those are 28, 36 and 45. Here I get the answer 28, 36, 45. If you guys write this, you will be given 3 marks for this answer. 3 marks, half each. Okay? So, what is the second part of this question? Second part of this question says, write a pseudo code that corresponds to the logic indicated by the flowchart. Okay, generating the pseudo code, that's easy. We have done this many times, so let's do it again. So you have to start by begin as usual. So you are saying begin. And next thing is you have x equals 1. So you are saying x equals 1. And t equals 1, you are saying t equals 1. Next thing is what? You have a loop. So what is the loop you are going to use? I am going to use while loop. While loop. That would be easy. So I am going to use do while what? T greater than 50 or less than 50? Greater than 50 or less than 50? Now right here, greater than 50 works no problem because this checks at the end. But there I am going to check at the beginning. Understood? So should I say greater than or less than? Less than. So I am saying t less than 50. What to do? What are the things I need to do is, first thing to do is displaying t. So display t, and next I am going to update x as x equals x plus 1. Next, I am going to update t as t equals t plus x, and that's it. So I have to end the loop saying end while, and I need to end the code by end. That's it, that's the pseudo code. Okay, so if you have that entirely completely done, which means you have 4 marks. 4 marks. And third part is the crucial part. Now, in the third part it says, state how to modify the given flowchart to display the number sequence 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, 36, 49. Okay then, here what I got is 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, 21, that sequence. And what I need to show right now is 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. That's enough for me. So what do I see right here? This is a triangular number, but this is right here is square numbers. So how am I going to update that code to get square numbers? Which means the second number should be 4. How am I going to do it? It's very simple. Instead of adding 1 to x, I am going to add 2 to x. Then what happens? See, x is initially 1 and now t is also initially 1. X gets 1 added. So 1 plus 2. Now I am saying 2. That's how I am going to update it. I am saying 2. So 1 plus 2, x becomes 3. And now 3 plus 1, t becomes 4. Okay, I got the first value done. Now I am going to check the second value. Do I get it? So in the second cycle, x is again added with 2, that is 3 plus 2, which is 5. And now 5 plus 4, I am getting 9. Am I getting the value? Of course I am getting the value. Okay, so it's very simple. Inside your answer, replacement should be happening right here or right here. So you're writing something like, in the third question, replace x equals x plus 1 by x equals x plus 2. That's it. That's all you need to do. And if you have that part correct, you get 3 marks again. So the whole question carries 10 marks. Right? 3 marks for the first one, 4 marks for the second one, and 3 marks again for the third one. Okay, so recapping what we have done in this program, initially what we had was 1 right here, so which means each time t will be displayed and x will be updated by x plus 1 and t will be updated by t plus x. So we have observed right here, it gives a sequence like 1, 3, 6, 10, 15. So the question, the first part asking is first 3 digits and the last 3 digits. So you can already get the first 3 digits, that is 1, 3, 6. And if you continue the sequence, since this is 50, you can go ahead, continue this, that's very easy. So you're continuing and at the end you are stopping right here, which is 45. So they are asking last 3 digits, so that is 28, 36 and 45. In the second half of the question, they're asking you to make the pseudocode. That's very easy, right? So you are constructing the pseudocode. The control structure you're using is the do while loop. And next thing is, they're asking if you need to get the square number sequence, how to update the code. So updating should happen right here if it is the flowchart, or right here if it is the pseudocode. So updating is pretty simple. What you have to do is adding 2 instead of 1. So in the third one, you are saying replace x equals x plus 1 by x equals x plus 2. Clear? Done? Okay, have the answer.